Hello everybody and welcome back to Simon Says. This is Simon Clavel playing on the Deadbeats Minecraft server. This area in front of my house has taken a bit of a beating. So many creepers. Anyway, so since last time I got myself a little wheat farm going here, just a simple one, because I figure, you know, it'd be a good idea to have something here. And yeah, let's just place a few trees down so I could get some more like birch wood. And it's all been going. How did you get out of the pen? It's all been going quite well, so I'm honestly really happy about that. As you can see, I've gotten a bit of a cow farm started here. It's not much, but I mean, it's there.
Oh!
And yeah, so things are going alright. I actually know the location of a cave. Well, no, I actually did do a little bit of caving off camera. I'd actually like to do some more caving. Something that I found was that, I don't know, it's, well, no, it's not something I found, it's just something that I was watching and I kind of was in agreement with. Vintage Beef, I recently put up a new episode of his vanilla series, and he found that, you know, getting levels through caving and fighting mobs and stuff was exciting. It's a lot more fun than just going to, like, say, the Ender and just getting levels like that. And yeah, it actually is something that I agree on. So, I mean, not that I can really access the Ender anyway, but yeah, that's something that I'm gonna try to stick to, I think. I don't think I have much in the way of food. I could make some food, but oh yeah, I found a bug recently where if you have an empty bucket, if you only have one empty bucket, like, not, for example, if you're filling up milk from like a stack of buckets or something, the last bucket in a stack always gets consumed and nothing, it just disappears basically. I think that's the only big issue that I've found so far in 13W19A. So just keep your eyes peeled for that. Also, the audio might be a little bit louder or might be breathing into the mic a little bit. I'm just trying it a different position. This is actually, the position that the mic is in right now is actually a similar position to how I had it in the past when I was messing around with it. But I think when I was moving things, I guess I just put it a bit more to the side. Anyway, so while that's cooking, let's make ourselves some bread real quick. There we go. But yeah, we're definitely going to need to get some food, which is part of the reason why I've got those cows there. And, oh, there's already some more grown wheat. So let's pick that. Get that out of the inventory. Actually, I should put some stuff away before I actually go to explore the other side of the island, basically. Because that's what I'm planning to go and do. Oh yeah, you may notice that there's a little bit of cobblestone here. Random creeper spawned in here, actually. And that wasn't really something that I was expecting, so it just kind of showed up and went boom. Is there anything else that I can take with me? I've got some steak. And that'll do for now, I think. Oh yeah, I also made some clay blocks. I haven't gotten into hardened clay yet because I know I kind of want to wait until I get more before I do that, but also, you know, I want to figure out a design that I would use with those blocks before I make and craft the stained blocks and stuff. Anyway, enough arguing, enough rambling. Let's go explore the north and northwest. I don't know why I had to check the direction in there when I knew that was north. Anyway, yeah, let's go around the island today. And already kind of been in this ravine. Not too much, but just a little bit of exploring. There's an abandoned mineshaft under there. And I nearly lost my stuff like twice or three times or something. I am a very good explorer. Anyway, so yeah, this island is proving to be quite interesting. Actually, I think I might still be getting a bit of lag from the Google Music uploader, and I think that is the case. I've just gone and paused it, and I might need to put some torches down in this area. Oh, there's a skeleton. Yeah, wow, this is just really freaking dark. One day I'll figure out how to make you guys normal villagers, but for now I have to kill you. So there are a couple of things that I actually do want to talk about while I go exploring today, and they don't have anything to do with depression. Isn't that great? But no, seriously, I do have some stuff to talk about. And I don't really have a list in front of me, and that's probably something that I should start doing. But you know, I'll do the best I can to remember like what my actual topics are. Awesome, there's some chickens. I'll have to remember that. So, Well, actually, yeah, there is one thing that I want to talk about in regards to the depression, anxiety stuff. I have finally made an appointment with a GP. I guess it's been a long time coming. Now I just have to... Oh, there's another ravine here. There's some lava. This is... Oh, man. But yes, that is next Tuesday. And I'm not entirely sure how long it's going to take. From what I gathered on the phone, is that a separate part? Is that a separate island? Looks like it. From what I gathered on the phone, the appointments are usually just like 15 minutes, and maybe that was always generally the case, but well, I've never really been to a doctor, no, that's not true. I have been sick before, but I mean, I've never really scheduled my own appointments. Oh, it looks like these islands are connected. So, you know what, I'm not actually going to go that a ways. I'm just going to go through the quote-unquote center of the island. But anyways, so yeah, I'm really happy with that, and even though, I don't want to say, like, my family is the cause of my depression, like, I'm not, oh geez, that actually doesn't look very natural, but they've probably contributed to a third ravine. This is amazing. But yeah, in any case, I've enlisted Mum to... Oh, and that is me forgetting to put Skype on Do Not Disturb when I'm recording. Mum has this blue folder, basically, with previous, like, assessments from psychologists, speech pathologists, guidance officers, or do I don't know, from the looks of things, it looks like they're kind of the same thing, maybe, or, I don't know, but, like, from stuff to do with, for example, my Asperger's, which, I don't know if this is worldwide or in Australia. I guess it's, there's a leading authority, worldwide somewhere, but, apparently, Asperger's is just being reassigned as part of the autism spectrum disorder. So, I guess that the autism spectrum disorder is like an umbrella term now. Not that I'm really complaining, because, I mean, you know, that's not really my place to complain anyway. Well, yeah, no, it's not. Like, I don't really care. You still get the general point. Anyway. So, yes, yeah, so it is this folder. And Mum believes that, like, we could take that to the GP when we go to see him. And I don't have any fish, so I can't even bother with, hello, goodbye. Well, there are a lot of ocelots here. I'm going to have to come back here and tame one day. I've never actually tamed an ocelot. It's, something I'm going to have to do while I'm here. And, like, not just previous assessments, but previous treatments? Okay, that's quite a weird generation there. So we know that, like, some of the antidepressants, well, no, it doesn't have any of the actual medications that I was on, but my mum herself actually does know, like, what I was on, or roughly what I was on, like, antidepressants, antipsychotics. Yes, it, I think what you will. These weird shadows, man. There we go. So I'm hoping that that's really, like, bringing that documentation along is going to help whoever's going to be seeing me to you know, basically get a better deal of, like, what I've been through and, like, how they might be able to treat me. I do not have a bed, and maybe I should have brought a bed. I don't know. I'm actually going to get this clay because, once again, snapshot. Whee! But yeah, anyway. Once again, I am recording this at a very awkward hour. Oh yeah, has anybody ever gotten this bug? Like, you're pressing forward, but you're kind of moving to the side a little bit. Anyway, that was just getting off topic. But, you know, off topic is good. And there's some dogs. I have one bone. Maybe I can get it to, let's see, where is it? There it is. There they are. Love? No. So, yeah, on Kickstarter recently, wow, this is actually a pretty huge island. I'm gonna have to, get a map of this sometime. Yeah, so on Kickstarter recently, there was a you know, guy developing a program called Epic Rewind, and what the guy basically wants it to do, and basically what it is doing, though we don't have any access to it yet, is, oh geez, there's a skeleton, is the intent, lots of ravines on my island, is to basically have a constant rolling buffer based on a set file size, like, well, not file size, but like RAM. So if you want to keep like a 300 megabyte buffer, and yeah, that's a basic example, and basically you would capture anything that is in it at the time of saving it. And so what you could do with that is basically capture capture things after they happen, which I think is something that a lot of people really want. And the reason that I believe that is that, that was a bit dumb. Well, I'm sure all of us have, you know, things that happen that we're not really recording for. And I'm sure there have been a couple of... Oh, yeah. By the way, this zombie killed me last time I was a while ago. If you remember correctly, I'll go back to Epic Rewind in a moment. But if you remember correctly, or if I remember correctly, in one of the latest updates, basically, a damaged zombie does more damage. So if you have a zombie that's, for example, like one hit from death, I assume he does a lot of damage. I think I got one-hitted by one. Yeah, it's still in development. Like, you can't really download it right now. From what I've read, the actual developer is, I don't know what I'm doing, is going to have something like a beta available in June, I believe? Sometime in June, where Kickstarter supporters will be able to test it and provide feedback. So that's what I'm going to be helping with. So you may see some test videos either on this channel or on my main well, this is kind of my main channel at the moment, but my side channel at Nurario. So you might see some extra videos there from testing that, and I don't know where I'm going. You know, I should probably actually dig. So yeah, that's something that I'm actually kind of excited for, because it is something that is, like, I think it's a big thing for us gamers. Oh, hello, get away from me. Oops. This is a nice drop though. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that, and I guess I'll give a little bit of impressions, as you know, once that's out for us testers. Another thing that I want to that I've been thinking about a lot today is a service called Flutter. Now, I don't think many people, well, there are a couple of people that know about this, but I don't think it's really heard of in our Let's Play community. So Flutter is basically a service that lets you do like micropayments. Like, for example, if there's something that you enjoy, like if you come across a site and you enjoy the site and you want to compensate them, or you know, like you enjoy, well, yeah, you enjoy the site basically. What you can do is there's like a widget or there's some companion add-ons that expose like links and, oh, hello skeleton. And so what you can do is you can flatter these things and oh my goodness, that is precious. Like, you set yourself like a monthly budget. So let's say you give yourself only 10 pounds a month. The site operates, no, euros, sorry. The primary currency on the site is euros, but it does translate. They do have conversion tools, so you can convert it to Australian pounds. Ugh. And, you know, basically see what you're actually going to pay. And, yeah, at the end of the month, oh, this looks like a, this is quite nice. I like that. Yeah, at the end of the month, the site, you know, takes all the things that you flattered in that month, and village, yes. Oh, you know what? I'm actually really happy about that because I didn't think there was going to be a village here. Oh, and I didn't think there was going to be creepers there. Do I have arrows? I do. Oh, jeez. Skeletons, zombies, and creepers. This is a wonderful. All right. I need to take care of you, like, right now. Alright. You get away from... Oh, thank you. Alright. Oh! No! Alright, what do I do? Health. Oh, crap. Just keep running around for a while. Avoid that creeper. And head into town. Oh. No, you appear to be, Hey, leave that guy alone. So yeah, basically splits up your monthly budget. Obviously you have to, like prepay, you know, like add funds to your account so you can pay these people. But you send flatters basically to people whose content you enjoy. And, you know, it's a nice idea. Like, I certainly support it. But a recent update, well, no, it's actually not that recent, it's like from March or something, but this update, I am happy about that, basically allow you to connect your account to things like SoundCloud and Flickr and YouTube and Vimeo and app.net and Twitter, although Twitter actually hates the fact that you can do this. And oh, this is actually a nice little village here. And basically, when you like content, you automatically flatter. That sounds interesting, but I don't have any emeralds. you know, you're automatically flattered at those things. So at the end of the month, assuming that the flatterer, the person that you're flattering, whatever, has an account, you will actually get like you can actually pay flatterers for you know, for making the stuff that they do. And that is I'm actually really excited about that, because think about it, like say you liked my video right now. Well, obviously not on this channel, because I'll explain why in a moment, but say for example you liked my video, well, what would happen would be that if you clicked the flatter button, or if you liked the video and you have a flatter account, then you know, you're basically saying, hey, thanks for making this cool new video, and you, like it's great for me, it's great for any content creators, like not just on YouTube and on SoundCloud, or even people who don't use these sites. Like if they just have their own site and they have like a flatter widget, it's seriously got great potential. And while I can't set it up on the Simon Says account, and the reason for that is, well, to put it simply, I migrated this page to this, yeah, I've migrated this channel to a Google, like to use Google Plus Pages as like a management system. Now you may wonder why I do that when I'm basically running this show on my own. And that is a good question, but in the future I think it'd be nice to have, for example, to have people upload their own videos onto my channel or something, if they have some, let's say they have something related to Simon Says, or I'm doing like a joint series with them, and they are doing the uploading, or they are doing the editing and stuff, and they don't have to want to rely on me to, you know, to be around to upload it, or things like that. Anyway, so yeah, I would honestly be kind of thrilled if other people wanted to give Flatter a try, because I think that as Let's Players, it'd be a great thing, basically, to be compensated for our videos, even if it's just a little bit a month from only a few people. Like, even if it's a little bit from like one person a month, like even that little bit is seeing money, like seeing people send you money is probably such a great feeling. I say probably because, believe it or not, I don't really like it when people send me money. Well, okay, maybe I do, but I don't know, I just find it hard to ask for money. You know, I guess it's both a moral thing, and it's just, no, amoral, not as in immoral, but yeah, it's interesting. While you probably could flatter my content directly, but I might not be able to actually receive it. But in the meantime, there is a link on the, at the top of my profile that says like my stuff, Flatterer. And if you do have a Flatterer account, or you want to get a Flatterer account and help support Let's Players and any other kind of content creator, then you know, feel free to use it if you like any of my content. I may also go back into monetizing my videos. I haven't been sure about that for a while. Like, this could be the end of the island. Doesn't look like it here though. Like, I haven't been sure about monetizing because I think after everything, like I think I had ads going for a few months at least since Dungeons of Dreadmoor, and then of course there's the Minecraft series, which, you know, Mojang is okay with, but oh no, it keeps going. I'm gonna have to end the episode off at the other side of this island, or even make a hidey hole a la Kurt J-Mac from Minecraft, or Firelands or Bust, whichever you prefer to know him by. What was I saying? Oh yeah, advertising. Yeah, throughout the time that I actually did monetize videos, I think I only, oh my god, I think I only earned about, what was it, 12 cents? And an educated guess would be that that is because of things like ad blockers, which I understand people use, and it's okay to use ad blockers, like in general. But that said, you know, like if, like for example, disable it on YouTube. I mean, yeah, ads aren't really that invasive, and I think that, you know, supporting your favorite channels through, you know, a little bit of monetization, is, it really does go a long way to help us to, you know, to improve our content and to get more, like, to, for example, to buy games and stuff that we can play for you guys and the like. Speaking of monetization though, and I'm probably gonna have to make a hidey hole in a minute. Yeah, but speaking of monetization, like, I've been thinking about networks, like, you know, like channel networks, monetization networks, partner networks, basically. And well, it's interesting because, like, I'm honestly kind of interested. I might take the opportunity and partner up, as it were. But I don't know how, like, I might have to talk to somebody and I'll ask somebody, or even I could ask you guys, like, because I'm sure that some previous videos could be in trouble, even though, oh, let's see. What were the previous games I did? I started off with Binding of Isaac. I said that in video 200, and then I moved on to Toby's Vertical Adventure, Bastion, Super Mario Bros. Deluxe, the ROM hack. It was like built on, it was built on Super Mario World, Blast Core. Okay, so I did actually. Okay. But yeah, so. But you know, I might still have, like, music that I might have used in those older videos that might come under scrutiny. But I might actually talk to a network. Of course, it'd mean a little bit more work on my part, but I think, you know, I think doing this as a hobby, I really like to do this, and it might be a good idea, I think, to maybe get a little bit more serious in doing YouTube stuff, because, well, for the most part, oh, that is not a pickaxe. It'd be good to, get paid doing what I love to do. I know that my Canadian Underground series isn't doing too well, but I think I'm going to keep that going because, wow, my voice is starting to go. because even though I'm only getting like one or two views per video, and I know who elite, who that one of those views are, even though I only get that many views on the video, I think I want to have that series there, but just because it's not Minecraft, like, I don't want to get, you know, I don't want to have too much Minecraft on this channel. I do want to do other things now and then. Speaking of, I am going to start a new series in, well, not a new series, but, well, you'll see. But keep an eye out for that. But anyway, so I'm going to finish it up here because it's probably been half an hour or more and I need to rest my voice. And it's 11 o'clock, so I shouldn't be talking so loud. So thank you for watching, everybody. And this has been Simon Flavel with Dead Beats Minecraft. And, join me next time when I guess we explore more of the island. This is a massive island. I didn't expect this much, honestly. But I'm glad for the fact. And remember, support your favorite, not even like your favorite Let's Play. It's like, if you enjoy a video, just like it. Or flatter it or something. Because, honestly, I enjoy, I would really enjoy that. And supporting us in any way really does help. So, see you guys next time. Grass is grow.